Storm is coming. Mankind faces ruin and despair. The world is changing, yet hope remains in the hearts of the people. We go about our daily lives never knowing the forces that can change our destinies forever. We are oblivious, ignorant like sheep to the slaughter. This night, in the year of our Lord 1047, marks the beginning of our journey together. A journey into darkness, into madness. I watch him from the shadows. Is he the one? He has come far already, but he will be tested, tested to the very limits of human endurance and beyond. This night he rides looking for the old gods, armed with an amulet that has led him here. Tonight he will begin his journey into oblivion. The struggle for supremacy is eternal, inevitable. Victory is the natural objective of every creature on this world. They will kill and die for their kind to dominate. Some call this eternal struggle equilibrium, the balance between light and darkness. These are dark times, times without hope. Men of faith claim that this is a test from God to strengthen our spirit. Perhaps this is true, or perhaps it is simply a pious lie. If it is true, darkness has come to engulf one's proud humanity, and we are witnessing the end of mankind. Thank you.
Who are you?
I am Gabriel. I have traveled here seeking the Guardian of the Lake.
You are from the Order? They sent you?
How do I find him?
He will find you. In the forest.
Follow him into the old forest, watching him from afar. He is strong indeed. The one God comes to drive out the many, but here, in this place, God's influence is thin and threadbare. The old gods still hold sway here. Few venture this far into the wood. He is disturbed by dreams, dreams that gnaw at his very soul. He will rest for the night, but rest will not come easy. The battle has left him weakened, but he knows the dream will return, and though he fears nothing on this earth, yet his nightmares sap the strength within him and leave a cold grip on his heart. Tomorrow he will use the old hunting path. Long has it been in disuse, but for now he dreams. What motivates a man to confront the challenges that most of us would run from? Condemning him to solitude, exposing him to defeat and death. The answer is love. A force so powerful that all reason becomes blind to it, blind to all things, even the truth. Loss of love can make a man desperate. Desperate enough to do anything to bury the truth, to hide from its pain.
Guardian of the Lake. I will take you to him, but we must be quick. Climb onto my back. Hurry!
Thank you.
can travel no further. You will find what you seek ahead.
Alone again, with only his thoughts as company, he continues on his journey to find the one he seeks. Who or what was that strange creature? There is a power here that few know, a power that could have some influence on events. Perhaps the guardian of the lake is aware of him now and offers aid in his quest. There is just the small matter of the dead bog to overcome, a place that has claimed the lives of many of the Brotherhood. The smell of death is strong here, and danger lies around every corner, but nothing will stop him. Nothing will stand in his way.
Forgive me, brother, but my need is far greater than yours.
Thank you.
The stench of the bog fades into memory, and a land of great beauty lies before him, a paradise where nature lives in harmony with all living creatures, indeed, a refuge for those who wish it. He is close now, close to the old gods and the old ways, long forgotten by men. This kingdom was once revered by all, yet now only a small part remains. Soon even this will disappear. The amulet senses its master. Its journey is almost over. He will need all his strength now, all his wits. If he is to succeed here, if he is to convince the old god to help him.
Show yourself! The Brotherhood needs your help. I need your help.
I know who you are, Gabriel. I am the guardian of the Lake of Oblivion, where the living can communicate with the dead. Tell me, warrior, are you aware of what is happening in the world?
We have been deserted by God. Creatures from the void come to claim the souls of men, to wipe mankind from the face of the earth.
And what of the elders of your order? What do they think?
That God has not abandoned us. They believe that a powerful spell has been unleashed by someone or something. A spell that has isolated our world from the heavens, cutting us off from God, and allowing evil to flourish unchecked.
Why have the Brotherhood of Light sent you to the Lake of Oblivion?
They have dreamt that a message waits for me at this lake. A message that holds a clue to our salvation. I was instructed to seek you out, in the hope that you may show me the path.
The elders believe that these dreams are the last message from the heavens, and that you should know something that we are unaware of. Is that it?
Yes. My wife, Marie, was murdered not 2 days ago by the evil that roams these lands. Her soul and those of the recently departed are trapped here and cannot find peace.
And that is why they sent you to the Lake of Oblivion, because they believe that she is waiting for you here to deliver a message to you.
Yes. Will you help me?
Only the most deserving of the living are worthy of speaking to the dead. Are you worthy, Gabriel?
What does this mean? Tell me.
Only that you have passed the test. You appear worthy of entering the Lake of Oblivion. Make sure you have your daggers with you. One never knows when need may arise.
The test has shaken him. I see the doubt in his eyes as he heads towards the lake. So Pan is helping him now. That's good. Perhaps it bodes well. I wonder if he knows what awaits him here, in this place where the dead can contact the living. It is cold now. A chill wind blows through his heart. I can see it, feel it. He will need help if he is to succeed. He must not fail. He will not fail. Not now. Not yet. Not if I have anything to do with it.
Dagger, quickly!
Marie! Not there to save you.
There is nothing to forgive, my love. I am so happy to look upon your face again.
And I yours. My love, the elders of the Order hope that you can help us to understand what is happening. The world has been isolated from the heavens. Some believe that God has abandoned us. Can it be true?
I feel that the spirits are trying to talk to me. They whisper things to me. It is hard to understand them all. It is so dark, so many people crying. I cannot find them in the blackness. I'm scared. There is something else. A shadow is on my mind. You must help us, Gabriel.
What are they telling you? Who are they?
They are the spirits who founded your order. And that the power of the Lords of Shadow is the key. They talk of a prophecy. I don't understand what they mean. I can feel myself fading. I can hardly see you. Darkness is closing around me.
Marie,
I love you, Gabriel.
Don't go, Marie. I love you too. Why are you here? Who sent you?
I am Zobek, a warrior of your brotherhood. Pan and I are old acquaintances. He felt you would be in need of my assistance.
I have heard of you. I am sorry.
My name is Belmont.
I know who you are. Was that the spirit of someone you know?
Yes. It was my wife.
Forgive me. I couldn't help but overhear what she told you. It sounds like the spirits who founded our order are trying to tell us something very important through her.
What do you mean?
Only that the founders of the order seem to be using the dead to communicate with us. The prophecy has been secret for many centuries. It is known only to a select few. There is no way she could have known of it unless they managed to tell her somehow. Praise be to God.
What prophecy?
It is written that a pure-hearted warrior will claim the power of the Lords of Shadow as his own and use it in order to overcome all evil. It is said this warrior would become God's vassal on Earth, supremely powerful. He could do anything. The founding spirits have not abandoned us, Gabriel. Thanks to your Marie, we now know there is some hope. We have to enter the lands of the Dark Lords, you and I. We must reclaim the powers they hold and unite the heavens with this world once more. And don't you see, Gabriel? You can bring her back.
If what you say is true, then we need to work quickly and in secret. The Lords of Shadow must not suspect we're on their trail, or they will turn all of their attention towards us. We should take different routes, you and I. I will head for the Land of the Lycans. You leave for the territory of the Vampires and prepare the way. Then we must go on to the Lord of the Necromancers together. His realm lies furthest. Our enemy must suspect nothing.
Take this. It will allow you to absorb spiritual energy and will help cure your wounds. Good luck, my friend. May we be granted victory.
Thank you, brother. You have given me renewed hope.
We part ways, he and I. My instincts tell me he is filled with hope, a hope that will drive him ever onwards. Good. Perhaps he is the one, a warrior of pure heart, who can deliver us from all evil. Perhaps. I wonder what went through his mind when he saw her there, his beloved. Did he see his dreams, or did he see his future blown away like leaves on the wind? I spy him as he heads out towards the reaches of Pan's influence. A forest lies to the east that leads to the land of the lichens. The ruin of an ancient civilization is there, forgotten and decaying. Once a proud testament to man's ingenuity and vision, it has now been conquered by nature, as she claims all things for her own. He is becoming stronger with every step he takes. His prowess in battle is undeniable. He will need it now. Goblins are one thing, but there are other creatures in the dark places of the world, creatures who know nothing of his plight but fight for their very survival. Many fallen brothers are testament to this. Indeed, their bleached bones adorn the tortuous tunnels in this godforsaken place. He runs ever onward into peril. I wonder who the prey is, and who is the hunted. Perhaps when the time comes, these creatures will know fear as they look into the eye of their quarry. Go, my friend, save your love. So he has found another of Gandalf's upgrades. This was unforeseen, though it should prove useful in the challenges to come. The lost city of Aghata looms before him. I wonder if you know what truly lies ahead for you, Gabriel, what God has in store for you. The land of the lichens. This ruined city now belongs to their lord, and you can be sure he will not allow you to pass without forfeiture of your life. But in order to bring her back, you need to defeat him, my friend. You need to crush him into the dust, like the worm that he is.
Ah.
This ancient city occupies many layers, each one being the foundation for the next. It is a labyrinthine maze of dead ends and forgotten walkways. Danger lurks around every corner. He has shown great resilience, but this journey will take him longer than anticipated and deeper than any man has ever ventured in centuries. He will need all his wits to find an alternative route into the heart of the city, where his destiny awaits him. Agharta was once one of the greatest cities of the ancient world, but it didn't take long to fall under the onslaught of the Dark Lord. The lichens were innumerable, and the city was razed to the ground. The necromantic wars, as they were known, destroyed the advanced technologies that the Agharthians had closely guarded. Eventually the titans fell, and then the people were massacred one by one, or were turned into beasts, subservient to their new conqueror. None now remain to tell the tale.
Wait!
Thank you.
light.
Who is this strange girl? Surely she could not have survived alone in this hellhole. Gabriel follows her deep into the depths of the city. I wonder where she is leading him. It is strange. I hear no words, and yet it seems Gabriel is communicating with her in some way. Something tells me she has a part to play in all of this.
Did you see the power that resides within those crystals? The crystals can be really useful in combat. You can find crystal shards scattered all over the place. I often go in search of them.
How can I hear your voice if...
I'm not moving my lips. I have the gift. I can also read minds.
Who are you?
My name is Claudia, and he is my protector. He looks after me. In return, I catch evil souls so that he can absorb their energy. Without it, he will stop working. But there's something different about you. Well, you seem good somehow, so we won't kill you.
I'm relieved to hear it.
It's okay. Let me read your thoughts. No!
What is it? What's wrong?
You are here to kill the Lords of Shadow and take their power. You mean to save us all and bring the one you love back. I am not afraid. We are coming with you. You won't make it on your own.
No, Claudia. I must do this alone.
I know the way. You don't. You need me. You need him.
Very well.
Fate has played its hand, and now the die is set. I knew this child would play her part somehow, and it seems Gabriel has real help at last. It bodes well for our quest. The golem that protects the girl has something that could prove very useful in the end, something unforeseen. My dear friend, I see your destiny before me, and it is terrible indeed. And yet I have trust that all will be as I have hoped.
For thousands of years, this city overflowed with life. It was a sanctuary of magic, wisdom, and harmony. These people were the ones that created the crystals, which you've already seen. They didn't need armies for protection. Their powers were enough to thwart any threat. That is, until the Lycans came. Then the balance changed. Trolls, goblins, gremlins, creatures of nightmare besieged the city endlessly, day and night. Most fled. Others used their remaining powers to create huge titans to fight against the invaders. The battle lasted centuries until there was no stone left standing. No one left. Those that did not die in battle were captured and devoured. My father was one of the last. He hid me. He created the Black Knight to be my protector. We have been running ever since. The Titans outlived their creators and stayed here fighting against an enemy that outnumbered them until even they were defeated. All except one. Behind those doors awaits the last of those Titans. The only way to reach the Sanctuary of the Dark Lord is through that door. We will have to defeat the Titan if we wish to continue our journey. The door will only open with the power of a crystal. You need to find four shards to create a whole crystal. We will wait for you here while you look for them. We don't have time to lose, Gabriel. Find the areas where crystal shards grow. Now come back here. Do not waste the crystal, or you'll have to find another one. Behind that big door, the Titan awaits you. These statues seem to be here for a reason. I think these statues can move somehow.
Three companions enter the chamber of the Titans. What awaits them there is all that remains of the great technology of the Aghartians. This battle will test them all, and there is no going back now. The board is set, the pieces in play, and we shall see what occurs and who will emerge the victor. The child and her golem will help, and I hope once the battle is won, that Gabriel will have the courage to do what is necessary. Necessary for our quest to succeed, for there is still the matter of the Lords of Shadow, and their power is even more formidable.
Thank you. Don't get too close to the Titan. Look! Use it, Gabriel!
Titans are no more. She was the last of her kind.
Shall we go on?
We should rest. Night is coming. I know a place.
A great victory. Gabriel has won the trust of the girl, and together they wield a fearsome power. She is so young, so beautiful. Life is so fragile here on the edge of humanity. And yet in this unforgiving place, she has managed to survive with the help of her Black Knight protector. Sleep will come and take them soon. Tired and exhausted, they rest but this night. Fate once again comes calling, and I fear my friend will never be the same again.
First time I touched your face, I have seen my fate. I am ready.
not let the darkness possess you, Gabriel. You must remove the gauntlet from the night. It is a key, and the moment will come when you will be in great need of it.
No. I will have to continue without. I will not harm.
I am afraid it is far too late for that.
Dreams are a gateway to the mind, and now Gabriel has paid a terrible price for succumbing to his weariness. The many sleepless nights since his love was taken from him, the fear of falling into sleep, the nightmares that haunt him have all played their part. Did he murder this poor girl? Or is there some other explanation? Doubt gnaws at him now, eating his very soul. The golem protected this child for centuries, loved her dearly, and there was no way he would have let Gabriel live, yet alone give up the gauntlet. Few men could continue. Most would abandon the quest, but something deep inside forces him ever onwards. A dark force has taken hold, and all creatures of the night will come to fear him now.
Thank you.
Gabriel has fought long and hard to get to this point, and now he faces his stiffest challenge. The Dark Lord of the Lycans must be defeated if Gabriel stands any chance of bringing his beloved back. I fear he will suffer more than he knows once he discovers the truth, and yet his hatred and burning desire for revenge cannot be underestimated. He has the gauntlet, and he has Gandalf's weapon. He is a force that even the Dark Lord will struggle to deal with. Good. Soon he will overcome this evil. Soon the world will be free of the Lords of Shadow, and plans long dreamt of will come to fruition. Go, my friend, go and break this creature once and for all.
I have come to fulfill the prophecy.
My acolytes were not lying. A warrior from the Brotherhood, here on Lycan soil. I wonder, warrior, if you know where you are and who I am.
I am on desecrated land, and you and those of your clan do not deserve to live.
You say you are here to fulfill a prophecy.
You and the other Lords of Shadow are protecting a power in your sanctuaries. I have come to reclaim that power.
You, alone, you dare enter my inner sanctum and dictate your petty mortal terms to me. I am immortal, little man. And your pathetic prophecy is known to me, but you are ignorant. Ignorant of the real truth of your situation.
It is you who are ignorant. Ignorant of the pain and suffering you have brought to this land.
Hear me. Many centuries ago, three great warriors founded the Brotherhood of Light, the order to which you belong. Their sole purpose was to serve God and defeat the devil. For decades, the founders fought fiercely against the spawns of Satan, and finally tipped the equilibrium in God's favor. Such was their commitment to the crusade, that their studies in holy enlightenment led them to three sacred places, where the power of God converged with such intensity that it forged a bridge between the spiritual and the real. The founders used that power to purify themselves, abandoning their human forms and transforming them into spiritual beings whose power was second only to God's.
You tell me nothing that I did not already know, beast.
Little did they realize that what they left behind were not their carcasses devoid of souls, but instead the dark sides of themselves. Don't you see? That is how we came to be. We, who you call the Lords of Shadow.
No. You lie.
This place is where one of your founders ascended into heaven, and where I was born. This is the place where, according to your prophecy, a warrior of light will reclaim the power of my beloved brother in heaven, and I too will diminish. If that were to occur, he would die with me, because we are still the same being.
He and I, still connected.
Kill me, and you kill him. Kill us all, and you will kill the saintly founders of your own order. Brother, even you have to smile at the irony of it all. Perhaps he is willing to sacrifice himself for you. For the greater good. I, however, am not. I am Cornell, Lord of the Lycan. Your skills are no match for mine!
Make haste, my love. Reclaim the power before it is lost.
Oblivion. Sempiternum. Daemonis.
Must unite the two that remain. Come with me. Our time is running out.
The deed is done. Cornell is no more. Such a pity that the Brotherhood of Light, the order to which we both belong, should also be the reason why the world is in such chaos. Gabriel, you have proven your worth, my friend. You have a piece of the God Mask. It is said this relic can bring back the dead. It is said this relic can bestow power beyond any man's reckoning. Now, with the help of the old god, he heads toward the land of the vampires and further into the heart of darkness.
Where are we? What is this place?
The Crow's Pass. The land of the vampires lies beyond those hills. A powerful witch protects this domain. I can go no further.
Who are you? And why do you help me?
You may think I am helping you, but you would be wrong. I serve no one. You would do well to remember that.
Thank you.
It is a sad tale of the witch who guards this fortress. A sad tale of love lost. A tale not so dissimilar to our brave hero. Yet pity is not something he can feel anymore. He is blind to it. The pity of these so-called evil creatures will be laid aside for revenge. And so goodbye, once beautiful Malphas. You will trouble mankind no more, and when you are gone into the void, know that love destroyed you in the end.
Thank you.
So it seems Pan has saved Gabriel once more. His arrival most fortuitous. Gabriel now enters the outskirts of the vampire's territory. A cold winter has gripped this land for centuries, driving out the inhabitants to warmer climes. Those stubborn enough to stay have contended with the cold death that visits them each and every night, taking their loved ones away forever. The vampires thrive in the cold and terrorize the living who crave warmth and companionship. This night a warrior will come, a knight in shining armor with death at his side. He comes for you, creatures of the night. This village is one of the last vestiges of human civilization left in this place of death and cold. It lies not far from the vampire's castle, our next objective. I have some matters to attend to here, matters that could spoil our plans. I will deal with them and try to rendezvous with Gabriel later. He has not slept in days, not since the girl. The pain is etched on his face still. But in his soul, only hatred drives him. We will not speak of it. He must not know I have seen everything, that I have followed him this far. Thank God that you are still among the living, my friend.
The Lycan Lord has been defeated. I have his power. What happened here?
I congratulate you on your victory. But these fellows were not so fortunate. Word has spread of our quest. The vampire clan have slaughtered this entire village. And now, they are expecting us. That abbey. I am told the abbot possesses an ancient relic that harnesses the power of the sun. It is said to be capable of burning vampires and reducing them to ashes. That relic protects the abbey and all who take refuge there. But the abbot has barricaded himself inside and filled the building with deadly traps to deter visitors. After years of isolation, some say he has been driven quite mad. He resides up there, in the tallest of the towers. If we could persuade him to give the relic to us, it would give us a tremendous advantage over the vampires. But it won't be easy.
Mad or not, damn him for not protecting his people.
Ghouls! Block their escape!
Come.
Help me, Zobek. We can only knock down the statue if we do it together.
I'm coming!
We delve deep below the abbey, ready to face the evil confronting us. The abbot, Vincent Dorin, was once a good and kindly man who helped the people of Wygol. But now he has become a devious coward who has holed himself up in the abbey and rigged it with traps of cunning. The people, unprotected, have paid a heavy price for his treachery. Night has fallen outside, and we will be open to vampire attack at any time. We must be on our guard. We must work together if we are to succeed in acquiring the relic that the abbot guards. This will help us greatly in defeating the vampiric horde later.
May help us open the door.
I need your help with the crowbar, Zobek.
That's a good idea. Go through to the other side! Quickly! Holy beast!
The traps laid by the abbot have proved tricky, and yet we have managed to break into the inner cloisters, and the library is close at hand, if memory serves. My friend looks weary and troubled, the weight of the world on his shoulders. I can see he is holding a terrible secret deep within. He is trying to bury it, and in its place, the anger is taking over. We must not delay. We must find Dorin and take what we need before we are dragged down with the guilt. The need of the many outweighs those of the few now. We can shed no tears for those lost. We must be strong, and we must destroy the Lords of Shadow at any cost.
I'm sure there must be a way of entering the library from here.
I'll hold them back.
Here it is. I found it. Get out of here. I'll keep the trap door open.
The tower at the Abbey of Wygol was once a place where men of God sought knowledge and protected the people with Christ's love. Now it is the refuge of a man driven insane by fear. Dorin has abandoned his people to death or worse. A powerful relic keeps the vampires at bay, and we must take it if we stand any chance against the Dark Lord's minions. I know of a secret way that will take me to the top of the tower by a different path. Gabriel will have to find his own way for now.
Where's the abbot?
Inside.
No! No! Get away from me! I know who you are. The devil has sent you. You are demons who serve him. He told me you'd come. He does it to torment me.
Your people perished while you hid behind the one thing that could have saved them. You don't deserve to call yourself a man of God.
Gabriel.
No! It's mine! You can't take it!
There is a need far greater than yours.
You cannot take it! You are not worthy! Don't leave me here, you dogs! Curse you! Damn you to hell!
Please, help us.
What is it? What's happening?
They want you, sir. They want you alone. You must go to the village, or they will kill us all.
You do realize it's a trap.
I know. But still, I must go.
Do what you must. I'll take care of the boy.
The power to defeat the vampires is now in our hands, and that bastard Dorin has no doubt met his maker. If anyone deserved death, it is he. No one will shed a tear for his miserable life. Countless others have met the same fate by his hand. The quest is going well. We have what we need to confront the Dark Lord. and I sense Gabriel's determination to see this through. The vampires must know we have the relic, and I am sure they will move to stop us if they can. Wygol village is safe, for now. The vampires have lost one of their commanders, Brawna, and news will travel back to the Dark Lord quickly. This is a blow, but it won't take long for them to regroup. Luckily, one of the villagers has revealed to us a secret path into the demon's castle. This will lead Gabriel into the sewers, and then up into the very jaws of death. The villagers called him God's savior, and his weapon they called Vampire Killer. Ah, Gandolfi, how that would make you smile. As for me, once my business here is done, I shall follow my friend and aid him where I can.
Thank you.
Despite his best efforts to try entering the castle unnoticed, the vampires know that Gabriel is coming. Night is fast approaching, and soon he will have to use all his wits and powers to defeat what nightmares inhabit this place of death and decay. His strength grows by the day, and yet his hate intensifies deep within. He eats little and sleeps less. She is there in his thoughts, his beloved Marie. He knows that his journey is far from over. This castle, I fear, will push him into the abyss from which there is no escape. It seems getting into the castle will be more difficult than first thought. Gabriel will have to navigate the maze gardens. In this place, a man can be lost forever, or devoured by the creatures that haunt its labyrinthine corridors. These gardens were once the most beautiful in all Europe, and many pilgrims would visit the castle grounds from lands far away to witness their timeless beauty. Now they lie wasted and rotten, decaying as their master lives on. Time is running out. Night is almost upon us. Soon the castle will be swarming with vampires. Those who are the most powerful of their kind are able to take on the appearance of high-born humans. Gabriel must be on his guard now, for appearances can be deceptive. I have heard that in this place one may face one's deadliest foes without realizing it until it is too late.
Thank you. Hello. Have you come to play? The board is ready for you. Do you like it?
I'm looking for...
Don't you want to play?
I am here for the Dark Lord.
I'll tell you where she is, if you play my game.
She?
Mother doesn't like visitors. But I'll show you where she is, if you play!
I don't have time for your games. I must find her now.
Then I won't help you!
Fine.
You won't ever find her. Only I know the secret way. I'll let you make the first move. It's not fair! I want to win! But you have earned the right to continue on your journey.
She has the body of an innocent child, yet the wits and cunning of a seasoned predator. She will kill Gabriel in a heartbeat if she could. Beautiful Laura, who was turned many centuries ago, has lived a lonely, cruel existence ever since. Gabriel will have to be very careful from now on, as he can be sure that her mother, the one who commands here, is now fully aware of his presence, and that Laura herself still has some part to play in our tale. The butcher who commanded the castle kitchens fed the corpses of the dead to the ghouls. The efficiency of the queen's household is formidable indeed. The vampires drain the blood, and the ghouls feed on the remains. Nothing is left. Using his powers is making Gabriel far stronger than I anticipated. He will need more than physical prowess when he faces her. She can put a glamour upon his heart that will tempt him to forget everything he knows, even his beloved. She holds the next piece of the mask, and I fear that he will fall at the last. This part of the castle was once where acclaimed scientist Friedrich von Frankenstein conducted his experiments into artificial life. He was quite mad, and often would conduct horrific and depraved acts, trying to discover the secrets of life itself. His own demise was equally gruesome. The vampire queen took him, but kept him alive thus over many centuries. She fed on him daily, keeping him at the brink of death, yet living and aware. Why she did this is only known to a few. She once loved life and loved living things, and before she became a Lord of Shadow, she vowed she would punish Frankenstein for his vile acts. As a Dark Lord, she was able to keep her word. Gabriel has finally defeated Frankenstein's abomination. This hellish place is enough to thwart any man's resolve, and yet Gabriel seems completely willing to continue to the bitter end. I hardly recognize my old friend now. A steely resolve has taken hold, and compassion is now gone from his heart. He doesn't sleep these days, more's the pity. He just rages at the world and those creatures that dare to confront him. This next challenge will tax his mind further, and I fear it may break it forever.
It's not fair! I never lose! You're a cheat, and you're going to pay! Now, play with my toys! I told you, I was going to win! Nobody beats me! Do you hear? Nobody! Don't resist. Embrace sweet death.
Marie.
Fight it, Gabriel. This is not your time. Not now. Too much relies on you.
I have nothing left. I have done questionable things. I have failed.
I envy you. I envy you both. I don't want to play anymore.
Curious, isn't it? Love can be a powerful weapon, it seems, even to those who are dead. Laura has spared him. Though she has the power to take his life, she has given it back, and all for love. Perhaps she remembers her true mother's arms around her, comforting her before she became this creature. Perhaps she remembers the feelings of love thought long lost to her heart all those years ago. A child's love is without bitterness or boundaries, a pure love. I wonder what will become of her, this lost soul, when we kill her present mother and send her to the pits of hell where she belongs. The vampire's mercy is playing on his thoughts. I see that clearly on his face. Perhaps Laura reminded him of poor Claudia. Seeing his beloved Marie again has brought it all back to him. Marie's love is all he has now, and the hope of holding her again, the only hope. He is close now, close to the bitch who commands these vampire vermin. Gabriel will make her pay for the injustices he has felt at her hands. She is powerful. She will try every trick in the book to tempt him to her cause. There is just the small matter of the clockwork tower to overcome first. Another mad invention of Frankenstein that I hope will only delay his sweet revenge. Giant mechanisms and gears continue to turn, but Gabriel continues to foil them. He is now in the heart of evil. Darkness is all around, surrounding him from all sides. Here he will meet the brother of the one he destroyed in the village. His name is Olrox. The two brothers have been her greatest champions, yet I sense their reign of evil is ending here tonight. Olrox and his brother Brawner are traitors who took sides with the Queen when she became one of the Dark Lords. He has wreaked terror on the lands ever since. But now he will meet one who is greater, more powerful than he, one who will deliver a message without any mercy. Olrox, meet Gabriel Belmont and his vampire killer.
You shall not pass through here.
You shall not stand in my way.
The Dark Lady watches over you. Challenge my lady!
The blood of Olrocks has opened the way to the Queen. She holds the next piece of the God Mask, which Gabriel must acquire if he is to be with his beloved again. She will try to seduce him, to glamour him, but he will see through her mask, I'm sure of it. He is so very strong now, and even she must fear her own death at his hands. I can smell her fear, her stench. Vampires can sense the living, but the dead she cannot. She knows Gabriel is here, yet she cannot sense death close at hand also. She knows what it is he wants. Poor, beautiful Carmilla, you will cry bloody tears before this night has ended.
I am told that you are looking for me, warrior. That you seek to obtain the power of my other half. You are brave and handsome. Would you not prefer to stay with me forever? I can show you many things, many pleasures.
Your empty promises mean nothing to me. You and your brothers have betrayed us all. You are the reason why the world is in darkness.
You are a fool, Gabriel. You think I don't know who you are? My sister, in her piety, wanted nothing but good for the world. But in her arrogance, she begat me and brought doom upon herself. Mankind is ruined. And you must choose sides, warrior.
I choose life, not death and decay as you have.
Death is merely a question of perspective. We are not so different, you and I. Your God cannot save you now. You will be one of us eventually. It is inevitable.
No. I will take the three powers and unite them.
You would kill those who founded your own holy order. You are even more cold-blooded than I. Who is the real monster here, Gabriel? You poor, deluded fool. You think you can bring someone back from the dead, don't you? Someone you love. You are betrayed. There is no resurrection. Only this living death you see before you. Join her then.
become one with us.
Oblivion. Sempiternum. Daemonis.
Soon, the destiny of every living being will be in the palm of your hand.
I now know that the founders of the Order created the Lords of Shadow. They are one and the same. They ascended into heaven as pure spirits, but left behind their dark sides. Why are we paying the price for their arrogance and stupidity? Tell me, what am I fighting for?
Only when we look inside ourselves can we truly begin to understand.
What is this sorcery?
How far are you prepared to go to uncover the truth?
So Pan comes again with words of wisdom and advice for our hero. Gabriel is angry now. Carmilla's betrayal has made him question his own faith. The Brotherhood means nothing to him anymore. He only wants his Marie back. He now has two pieces of the mask and only one more to find to make it complete. He must travel now to the land of the dead, and he must face the final lord, Death himself. There are still many leagues to travel, and I cannot risk being seen, for I doubt even one of his Brotherhood could help him now. He must go where none may follow. Into the abyss. The stench of death is strong. A witch holds power here, but I sense Gabriel is more than a match for her. The bones of his fellow warriors litter the place, but he seems oblivious to them. Stoic and determined to move forward, he doggedly fights on. He has not slept for days, he rests only briefly. I sometimes hear him talking to her, telling her he loves her, that they will be together again. In the dark, he weeps for her, or perhaps it is for his own lost soul.
Lost your way? Oh, lost your way? Master told Baba you would come.
Who is your master?
The king, of course. The king of the angels. Lost your way, then? Baba can help. Baba knows the path.
Where is it? Where must I go?
Only in the music box can blue rose grow. Baba wants to be young and pretty again. Bring Baba blue rose. Baba will show you the way to the land of the dead. Baba, shrink you small enough to enter the box. Inside, you must pass the test and bring Baba Rose back. Baba will be young again. Oh, yes! Box locked. Scarecrows took keys. Oh, bad scarecrows. Keys of three. Bring me three, and you will see. Baba glad to set you free. Find keys and bring to Baba. Baba not lie to you. Three keys. Go no further without the keys.
I will get them for you, but you must promise to help me.
Yes, yes, promise I will. Keys first. Go, go!
Good.
Good. Now, Baba, put you inside the box.
What?
Close your eyes, or spell will blind you.
The old hag has cast a spell on Gabriel, making him very small. Small enough to enter the music box and retrieve the blue rose she so obviously desires. This old witch has me nervous. Something she said has filled me with disquiet. She mentioned the King of the Angels. I am sure I heard her correctly. What does this mean? Why do I have this feeling of dread? I hope Gabriel will succeed, and quickly, so that we may be on our way. When he has gone, I will kill this evil crow, so that she may not be a danger to anyone else ever again.
Find blue rose for Baba.
Baba,
Yes, my good knight. Blue Rose is the... The rose. Give to Papa. Give to Papa.
Here.
Careful. Oh, pretty. Oh, pretty.
Now, keep your promise.
Of course, of course. Baba, good woman. Baba, not lie.
Baba Yaga sent our hero to the Titan's graveyard, and I have sent her soul to the underworld. She will trouble us no more. Now my friend enters the land of the dead, and his final battle is coming. I must find my own path and try to meet with him at some point. For now he is on his own. The land requires sacrifice. Sacrifice I hope that he can make, because without it he will not get very far. I must have faith in him now. The seed was sown long ago, and it flowers beautifully. He has come this far down the path. I must believe that he will go all the way. Powerful necromancers have used this once sacred ground to build an army of the dead. Conquering nearby lands, legions of zombies have devoured the living and given rise to this desolation. No man has traveled here without meeting death. Gabriel now faces his toughest challenge. He now bangs his fists on the very doors of hell on earth, and the Lord who commands here is listening. Waiting for him, smiling.
It appears that our paths cross once more.
But one path must end here.
I grow tired of your riddles. Speak clearly for once.
Nothing is ever completely clear, warrior. You are shrouded in darkness. You act as though blind to the truth. Let me enlighten you.
Let's see how powerful you are without your magic. Don't hold back! Fight! Come on! Attack the Gabriel! take your precious light power back. You cannot cull their light with light, fool. You are not the only one with magic energy, dear. Having to realize how light and shadow counter each other.
Why? Why did you make me fight you?
Because this is how it must be. We must all make sacrifices in order to find redemption.
No, I did not want this. I did not ask for this.
Blood must be spilt for this path to be opened to you. I accept my fate. Can you accept yours?
I am not worthy. I am not of pure heart.
So the old god is dead. It has come to this at last. The blood of a god has opened the way. Good, Gabriel, very good. There is only one true god, and all usurpers must be cast aside, though Pan's sacrifice was not in vain. Now our warrior of light can proceed to his final destiny. The Lord of the Dead is the most powerful of the Lords of Shadow. Gabriel will need every ounce of his being to defeat him. I worry for him, though. His mind is tired, broken even. He questions his faith. He questions his heart. Can he succeed? Come, my friend, just a bit further, and you shall see your Marie again. Fueled by the very flames of hell itself, the crematory oven is where the gravedigger does his ghastly work. A powerful demon, whose mighty shovel can cleave a man in two with one stroke, the gravedigger will rip the very soul from Gabriel, given half the chance. Yet I sense that our hero is more than a match for this creature. This could be interesting indeed. I sense Gabriel's rage welling up within him, and I wonder who is the more terrible, our hero or the demon. And so it begins. The necromancer's abyss lies at his feet. He is dark and terrible, and the cries of the dead follow him wherever he goes. There is nothing but hate in his heart. Hate for those who have taken his beloved, who have made him do terrible things, who have taken his humanity. Now, reap the whirlwind, scions of death, for comes the Prince of Darkness. Look at him, so dark, so beautiful. He has come for his revenge, and he shall have it. A killing machine without remorse, without pity. What has happened to you, Gabriel? What have you become? Love has blinded you, but you have changed, my friend. Your quest is almost over. The dream is in sight. Now you must face death, and you must defeat it. The mask is a powerful device, and he who wields it can do anything. Bring back the dead, rule the world, destroy the universe, challenge God himself. You are the one, Gabriel. You are the one.
Impressive, warrior. I'm amazed you've come this far.
I have come to end this, sorcerer.
By whose authority? What right do you have to judge me when so much blood has been spilt by your own hands? Look at you. You revel in death. We are one and the same, you and I.
You will not stop me.
No, I will not stop you. Look upon me, hypocrite. Gaze upon glorious death.
And now the final battle is come. Marie is waiting for you, my friend. She knows what you have done. She knows everything. Marie has hoped all this time that you would save the world, and here you are, on the brink of it. You stand upon a knife edge. She has kept faith in you despite everything. Now you must fulfill your destiny, and the truth will out. I will help you, old friend. I will be with you in this, your moment of victory.
Congratulations. You have done well, my friend. I see you have united the powers. Excellent.
We can now end this, once and for all. Come.
Yes. Let's bring an end to this charade. Finally, it is time for the truth. Let us remove our masks.
You are the Lord of the Necromancers. The final Lord.
Now you begin to understand. Yes, Gabriel. It was I who cast the spell that separated the earth from the heavens. I knew this would force my brothers and sister in heaven to contact the Order here on earth. The prophecy was their little ray of hope in the darkness. We Lords of Shadow, as you call us, have been impotent for far too long. Fixed in an uneasy truce for many centuries, each possessing our share of the power, but each unable to have mastery over the others. Until now. I grew so tired of these years of proliferation, a constant truce between the three of us, each unwilling to concede or cooperate with the others. They were too blind to see the potential in the power we held. If only it were combined. I desired that ultimate power and was prepared to probe the very depths of hell in search of knowledge to acquire it. I fought hordes of demons and became strong. Then a force so vast and terrible entered into me, expanding my knowledge of the dark arts until it reached unimagined heights. All I needed was someone to restore the luminous power of the spirits according to the prophecy, and you have been the perfect dupe. Of course, I couldn't arouse their suspicions that it was I who desired the power for my own. No, I used the prophecy as my cover. And you, my shining knight.
I will not allow you to stand in my way, Zobek.
I'm sure you won't. But you really have no say in the matter, my dear friend. I could quite easily kill you for your insolence. But fortunately, there is no need.
What do you mean?
The gauntlet will do it for me. As I told you, dark power is my dominion, forged in the pits of hell, no less. There was just the small matter of the child and her protector. But you came through with flying colors. I needed your strength of will and courage to complete the quest, but I couldn't risk you becoming too powerful. I needed to control you at the end, once you had murdered them. I knew you would never be able to challenge me whilst wearing it. Poor little Claudia. Such a sweet thing.
No!
You have exceeded even my wildest expectations, killing and butchering your way to victory. There is a terrible darkness in you, my friend. Your burning desire to resurrect your darling Marie has blinded you to it. As you slept, I was able to influence you with this mask. But even I did not foresee the beast that lay within. It was all too easy to make you kill them. Your penchant for murder and death were insatiable. You just needed a little nudge, and off you would go in search of the one thing that could bring her back. Yes, Gabriel, now you finally understand. It was you who murdered your wife.
No! You lie! Bastard!
Search your soul, Gabriel. You know it to be true. I was worried she would reveal my charade to you at the lake. But it seems she had a false hope that even a killer such as you could redeem himself and save the world. Even the child, Claudia, could see her own demise at your hands, and yet she also trusted in you to the bitter end. Glorious, isn't it? God himself sees you for what you are. A cold-blooded murderer. Beyond redemption? Beyond hope. Ah! 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 Let me free you of your heavy burden. Goodbye, old friend.
Hail, mighty Zobek.
Who's there? Who?
Don't you remember me? I came to you in the void. I granted you knowledge and power. Power that you could never have obtained on your own. Surely you haven't forgotten. In fact, I planted the idea for this whole elaborate ruse into your tiny mind in order to serve my own higher purpose. I no longer need your assistance. The power is now mine.
No! No!
Come for you. Before the end, you will bow down to me!
Gabriel. He's on his way. Come on, Gabriel.
Gabriel.
It is your time, Gabriel's promise. Don't be afraid. Come with us. Don't be afraid. Join us.
Get away from him. Don't wake him. Don't touch him. You cannot have him. If you take him, we are all lost. Darkness will triumph, and there will never, ever be peace or hope. We will be trapped here forever. Don't you see? We must grant him the power to go back.
Will he free us? Will we see the light that was promised?
I believe in him. His heart is pure. He is our last hope, our only hope.
So, he has abandoned you too. So be it. Join me. I will love you more than he. I was adored once above all others. I too didn't deserve to be cast out, abandoned. Now you know what that feels like, don't you? Hate can bring us back, give us strength, embrace it.
It is what is in men's hearts that he cares about. He loves you as he loves me. We have only to ask for forgiveness deep within ourselves and be welcomed back.
You monkeys don't deserve redemption. It is my divine right to rule by his side as an equal, or perhaps more than that.
You would rather rule in power and might than to offer forgiveness and love. This is why you are cast out, unholy one.
You dare to challenge me? You will die for your blasphemy. Your soul belongs to me. God doesn't love you! He let your beloved die!
Impossible! Is that the power of God?
Ah!
Stay back from me.
My love.
We are alive.
No. I do not want this. Why has my life been given back to me?
It is your fate. You have been given back what was wrongfully taken from you. To repent your sins. To make amends.
But without you?
You freed them all. You saved us all, my Gabriel.
I couldn't save you.
I knew I could not tell you, or despair would have eroded your resolve and everything would have been lost. I had faith in you, hoped that you would be strong enough to free the world, and you did not let me down.
I am not worthy of your faith, your love. I am nothing.
You are a good man, Gabriel. You are as God intended. Fallible, yet capable of great things. I loved you then, as I love you now. I see before me a man who has regained God's favor, and who has my forgiveness, and the forgiveness of all the lost souls of this world. You have saved us all, and you have saved yourself. The mask is a powerful device. It allows us to see through God's eyes.
Can it really bring the dead back?
Yes. Look. Too late for me, my love. I cannot come back.
No. No, don't go.
It is my time. The light is calling. I'm not afraid.
Please, stay. Stay with me.
It's beautiful, Gabriel. So beautiful. It's calling to me. Calling.
I love you, Marie. I love you.
An unusual hiding place for the Prince of Darkness. Don't you think?
Zobek.
Yes, old friend. It is I.
Where have you been all this time?
Out there, amongst the living. And what of you? Why have you been hiding all this time? Gabriel.
Don't you dare call me that. Isint Dracul.
No doubt you once were. But alas, look at you now. A mere shadow of your former self.
Shadow, am I? What do you want, old friend?
Satan's acolytes are readying for his imminent return. He is unlikely to welcome both of us with open arms. Don't you think? Help me stop him, or you and I will become his favorite pets. For all eternity. It is time to get out of this wretched tomb you have made for yourself. Stop skulking in the shadows. Don't you care that he will enslave you? I know what it is you yearn for.
I cannot die. Yet, I cannot live.
Help me, and I can free you of your immortality. Soon, it will be over.